What's up, it's Tanaya. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time, we're just gonna have, you know, a little vent session. By the title of this video, you already know what we're talking about. There has been so much attention being given through YouTube and a lot on TikTok just about like unprofessional black hairstylists and just unprofessional like beauty artists, like just people in the beauty industry in general. I'm in the beauty industry, but I'm a lash tech. But I have had like the last two appointments I've tried to book with a black hairstylist, it did not work out. And I'm gonna just talk to y'all about that first and then just give you my opinion on this whole thing. So I wanted to get box braids done. I can do my own box braids. I did these myself, but I wanted to get box braids done. Sometimes I'm lazy. I just want somebody else to do it. They could do it quicker than me. It comes out neater, whatever. The girl that I wanted to book, she didn't have any openings available. So I just DM'd her and just said, hey, if you have any cancellations, let me know. And she said, hey, I'm actually going to be opening some additional slots for this month, so just like stay on the lookout. So I'm like, okay, cool, thanks. So I saw her story, I don't know, maybe within 2 days, and she had additional openings. So I immediately went on her online booking site. She had an online booking site, I think through Acuity, similar to what I use. So she had an online booking site. I went on there, I saw, because she does knotless braids, so I wanted to do the knotless. And a friend of mine had gotten her braids done by her before, and they had came out really nice. So I went on there and I booked her for a Sunday. It was like in the afternoon, probably no later than 12 o'clock. So paid my deposit and everything. I was set, cool, boom. I had the address and everything, so I didn't have to reach out to her for any, like the address or anything like that. I had my braiding hair, like I was ready to go. I'm like reading her site, reading through the long paragraphs everybody has on their booking site, their policies. I also try to see if they post like what type of braiding hair they like to work with. Some artists like, or stylists like to work with a certain type of braiding hair. So I got my hair and everything. I was set. I was ready. My hair was washed and blow dried. I had to take down my hairstyle I had in already, wash my hair, blow dried my hair, just put it in two chunky braids and left the house. Because every time you go to get your hair done, you know you look ugly. Your hair look ugly at least. You know, so I was looking shot. And my fiance was dropping me off to the appointment because where she was working at, you know, wasn't in the best area. So I'm ready to go, set, no issues. And it's always this whole situation. If your stylist hits you up the morning of your appointment with a hey love, hey girl, you already know your appointment is probably canceled. And I was in the car. My fiance was dropping me off to the appointment because he was going to go to his mom's house because it was like the next town over and he would have just picked me up after. So I'm like, okay, cool, or whatever. So we're in the car on the parkway because she's like 30 minutes from where I live. And we almost halfway to the exit of like the town that she works out of. And I get a text. Hey girl, I'm so sorry. I have to cancel your appointment. I just, I don't feel well. She was working already in the shop and she said she doesn't feel well and she's gonna go home for the rest of the day. And if she'd like me to, you know, if I would like to reschedule with her, I guess she would have figured it out because she didn't have any other openings, but I guess she would have figured something out. I was so pissed off because it was like less than 30 minutes from the appointment time and you're telling me this. You know what I'm saying? On the other end, like I get it as somebody, I'm a lash artist, I get it, like you get sick, like things happen to us, we have emergencies, all other stuff, but I've never canceled on a client. I've canceled on one client who was over 30 minutes late and I said, you have to reschedule because she disrespected my time, okay? I've never no-showed on a client. I've never just out the blue canceled somebody's appointment. Never. Never will. So when that happened, and that's why like it set me off even more because I'm in the industry. So like when I see some foul stuff happen, like from a stylist to a client, and I'm the client, I'm like, oh no, boo boo, because I know I don't do hair, but I know how all the booking clients, the deposits, your policies, it's all kind of similar, you know, it's kind of similar. So I was pissed because I'm like, I would never do that to a client and just cancel them less than 30 minutes from their appointment time. She was very apologetic, but at the end of the day, my hair wasn't getting done and I look crappy, you know. And now I'm in the car and we gotta go to his mom's house because I ain't got nowhere else to go no more, and I look a mess. So I'm pissed off, so pissed off. I did everything on my part and I told her no thank you, just because she said, do you want to reschedule? I can refund you your deposit. And I just asked her politely to refund my deposit, and that was it. And I will never book her again, just off of that first experience. And I know sometimes we have to go through a lot, because like that one hairstylist is real, real good, so we'll put up with a lot of stuff. So I understand that. So that appointment got canceled. That was a Sunday. I went and I'm looking for other hairstylists because I'm like, well, maybe I can just get like a couple of feed-in braids, maybe like 6 feed-in braids going straight back, something like, which I know how to do myself as well, but I'm like, I wanted to have the stitch braid look. Oh, I wanted to just book, you know, some feed-in braids. So I'm looking for another stylist in my area. I'm on Instagram searching up and down. So I found another girl. So I'm like, okay. She's from like the same town that I'm from, or she works around the same town that I'm from. I see that she was following a couple girls that I went to school with and stuff. So I'm like, okay, cool. She has an online booking site as well. It's not a cutie, it's like a different one. So I booked with her and she actually like had openings and stuff. So I'm like, oh, cool. Because a lot of the times when you find like good people, they don't really have openings. So I'm like, okay, cool. So I booked on her online site and I just booked the feed and braids. It was for a Tuesday. It was for a Tuesday, I think at like 5:30. So, and I booked that time because that's the time that worked for me. So the morning of the appointment out with her, you got like a text confirmation, you got an email confirmation, you had to reply back to the text or email to confirm your appointment and stuff like that. I did everything. Or whatever, I already have braided hair, like my hair was already washed and blow dried from the Sunday appointment that didn't happen. And you know, it's the morning of my appointment, so I had her text message, her phone number, so I could send her a text message just to ask for the address, because that's the only thing that I didn't have. So I texted her that morning. I think it had to be like 9:30 before 10 a.m. I just texted her and said, hey, this is so and so. I have an appointment today at this time. I just wanted to know the address. I wish I still had these text messages, but my texts delete automatically after 30 days. So she goes, hey, are you still coming to the appointment? And I said, yes, I just need the address. So she gave me the address and I said, thanks. And the way she was texting me back and forth, I wish I had the exact text message, but you know when somebody has a bad vibe and they just sound like real smart or whatever, like they don't sound welcoming or anything through text, like that's the vibe that I was getting from her. So then she had texted me again or whatever, and she just said, hey, I'm just checking if you're still coming to your appointment later today or whatever, I just want to make sure that you're gonna show up. And I said, yeah. And I said, yeah, I just needed the address to the place, I'm still gonna show up or whatever, I'm coming or whatever. Now this was like, I don't know, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours before my appointment or whatever. So kid you not, it was like maybe 4:30, 4:45. She texted me and said that she has to cancel my appointment. No explanation, no reason, just my appointment is canceled. And that whole day, just from like the text encounter I had with her, like it wasn't like a warm feeling or anything. I just felt the bad vibes through the text, you know, that my appointment wasn't happening and it didn't happen. So she canceled it, no reason. She gave me a refund for my deposit and that was it. And I was just like, all I did was text this girl for the address. And it turned into this whole like conversation where she just seemed negative as hell. Like we barely exchanged that many words. I'm like, why is my appointment canceled last minute? I'm like, oh my gosh, what the heck? So after that, I did my own hair and I haven't booked anybody since. I rarely book stylists, but those two experiences back to back just made me say screw it, like I'm done. So in regards to this whole topic, it's just like, I understand where a lot of people are coming from, because you get canceled on last minute all the time, you know, or they take you late. They don't take you at the appointment time. And I understand from their point of view as a stylist, if your other clients before that client is running late and it pushes your day back. But what I don't understand that I'm seeing a lot of people point out on TikTok is stylists showing up super late. Because me as a lash tech, I show up on time for everybody. Like, I have never run late for anybody. Like, when I have people on a certain day, I'm getting to my place 30 minutes ahead of time to open up, clean up, and everything. And I'm there all day. Like, you know, I'm never late for anybody's appointment. So I don't understand, like, these girls making these videos saying, yeah, I'm her first appointment and she's an hour late or whatever, whatever. Now, I know situations happen where you may wake up late and stuff like that, but the way this is coming up is like this is happening on a regular, like this is the expected, you know? And it's not fair. Like, people who book an appointment time should be seen at that time. If you run it late, I understand. Like, if you're with another client, maybe they gotta wait 10 minutes or something, but dang, if you're really that behind, like, you can give a courtesy call, a courtesy friendly text message, something. But like, the way girls are saying that their experiences are, is just really freaking bad. Now, the whole come with your hair washed and blow dry thing is like a huge topic right now, because a lot of people are mad that they got to show up with their hair washed and blow dry. Me personally, I do not mind, because I like the way that I wash my hair. I like the way that I detangle my hair. I'm natural. I like the way I do my own hair. So I never really cared about that, but I understand where people are coming from. Like, if you paying to get a sew-in done, braids, or whatever the heck, you know, it would be nice to, you know, have a hair wash and blow dry included in that. So I kind of understand it, but I just think, like, this is all just getting out of hand. I just feel like a lot of stylists, if you are a stylist and you know you're unprofessional, you know you run late, you know your policies is crazy, you know, the whole if you come 2-3 minutes late, you cancel, or all these fees and extra fees, and you know, you eating while you doing people's hair or whatever service you doing. If you know you unprofessional, clean it up, because it gives like all of us a bad name if you're in the beauty industry and you provide services. You know, I've seen comments and TikTok saying like, oh yeah, that's why I don't book hairstylists that require a deposit, because they're not gonna have me out on a limb and just feel like they can do whatever they want to do. And I'm like, I require a deposit for lashes, but baby girl, I'm there. Like, you're getting your stuff done. I'm on time, okay? If anything, I probably finish you earlier than what you expected. I'm professional. So I'm like, I can't have all these other people messing it up for the ones that's actually like doing what they're supposed to do. So can we all like get on the same page here? You know, even though I'm a lash artist, totally different area, but still, like, you know, I can't have people out here saying they don't want to pay a deposit because they've had all these negative experiences with hairstylists. But I'm over here, you know, dotting my I's and crossing my T's, and my clients are happy. But now I got these new girls that's bringing all they negative experiences they have with hairstyles onto me. You know, and I ain't doing nothing. I deserve it. So we need to get this all together. Okay? Clean up your policies. If you got crazy behind policies, clean it up, you know? Clean it up. Be nicer. But on the flip side, as a lash artist, and I'm going to support the hairstylist in this, because there was a reason why your hairstylist made certain policies, as crazy as they may sound. I think that people who are like artists, stylists in the beauty industry, when they start to get a little snippy, or they may have a lot of rules, or like, you know, I think that they have had experiences with clients that made them that way. Now, the lateness, maybe they got
because there's a lot of clients who don't respect our time either. There's clients that don't give a about our time either. So, and I struggle with it as well, you know. I have clients who just think it's cool to come late or be like, oh, I'm on my way when it's like 2 minutes of their appointment time. There's people that don't respect our time, that don't respect our work, that nag us, calling us 24/7. You know, I'm sure they have those clients that turn them into these negative stylists. But that doesn't make it okay, because when you get in this industry, you have to be able to deal with a lot of different people. You're going to have to deal with the really good clients, and you have to deal with the bad clients. And you can't take out all that negative stuff that happened with the bad clients on everybody. So if you had a bad experience with a lash artist or a hairstylist, because I heard the lash artist stories as well. This one girl, I felt so bad for her. She made a TikTok video about a lash artist that she was going to. She was in a different state. I don't know if it was North Carolina. I feel like it was. And she was basically at her location, the lash salon, and the girl just canceled on her. Out of nowhere. No reason, nothing. Just canceled. And that lash artist makes it a habit to do that. And it's just like, you know, and I heard another story, people who lash in their house and, you know, you showing up to the house and then your appointment is just canceled for no reason, out of nowhere. And I'm like, people are doing this to y'all? Like this is a thing? Because it's so foreign, like, I don't do it. And it's just like stylists actually do this to y'all? I feel sorry for y'all. You know, I hope that if you've had a bad experience that you find a stylist that works for you. And if you find a stylist that works for you, please treat them right. You know, treat them right. All you got to do is show up. Show up on time. Be nice to them. Refer people to them. You know, refer good people to them. Okay? All right? Don't be referring people that you know don't be doing us right. Okay? Don't be referring people you know. Do not run on time. Don't always got their money right. Do not refer those kind of people, okay? That's going to give us a problem about a deposit because they don't want nobody having their card. Don't refer us to bad people, okay? Keep them over there. But if you guys had an experience with this stuff, leave a comment down below. Let's talk about it. And I'll see y'all in the next video.